Good morning, students. Welcome to the online classes of Trinity Memorial Senior Secondary School. Today, we are going to start our last unit for classes. The name of the unit is Celebrations and it's unit number 8. We are going to start with section number 1 and it's about Girls' Day. So, we are going to learn about the various festivals that are celebrated across the world, whether it's in India or in other countries. In this chapter, we'll read about one festival that is celebrated in India and the other one that is celebrated in Japan. So let's start it. I'll summarize the chapter for you. So the first festival that we are talking about is Paneer Kani, that is celebrated in Odisha, or you can call it Odisha. Okay, this is a tribal's honor. Okay, that they honor the girl child through festival. The government has declared 24th January as National Girl Child Day. This day will be marked by a series of events designed to celebrate the girl child. The events will continue right up to March 8, which is the International Women's Day. Now you must have heard about that 24th January is our Girls' Day. Okay, in Himachal Pradesh too, there was a girl in a village that was made the CM for one day. So, CM of the state for one day. Okay, so the government has declared 24th January as National Girls' Day. There are various events all around the country. Now, tribals in Odisha. The tribals of Odisha, Koraput district, celebrate the Paneer Kani festival to honor the girl child and seek divine blessings for them. So they honor the girl child. They celebrate it through festivals. Paneer Kani falls in the Hindu month of Chaitra, March, April. Parents of girls seek blessings of the Almighty to protect their daughters from evil spirits. The village priest fixes the day and date of the festival. Then he selects girls to take part in the festival. Now here, one thing that you need to note down is that 24th January is not fixed in the tribal festival. The village priest fixes the date and time of the festival. Now it comes in March or April. Okay. The parents of the girl, they seek blessings from the Almighty, that is the God. Okay. So that their daughters don't get affected from any evil spirits. Now, only those who have daughters can take part in this festival. This is the speciality of the festival, that only the parents having daughter can take part. Okay. For participating, the girl must be less than 9 years and not more than 7 years. Girls wear traditional attire, here is clothes, okay, and tribal jewelry. They dance to tribal music. The tribals of Koraput give a lot of importance to the girl child actually. They observe different types of festivals to celebrate the girl child. So, Koraput is one reason where people celebrate the birth of a girl. It's very rare in India actually. Now moving on to Japan festival, that is Hinamatsuri Dolls Festival in Japan. That's also celebrated as your girl's day. Hinamatsuri Dolls Festival takes place on March 3rd and celebrates Girls' Day. On this day, families pray for the happiness and prosperity of their daughters. Just like the one in the tribal areas of Odisha, in Japan also, families pray for their daughters' prosperity. The celebration takes place both inside the home and at the seashore. Seashore is the area near the sea. The celebrations are meant to ward off evil spirits from girls. Okay. To take off evil spirits from the girls. A girl's first girl's day is called her Hatsu Zeku. So you need to note down, this is important one, that the first girl's day celebration for a girl is known as Hatsu Zeku for her. Okay. On a girl's Hatsu Zeku, it is very popular for the girl's grandparents to buy her a display of dolls. This display can have up to 7 tires. These are the tires, 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th and 7th. These are the tires here, okay? You can see in the picture too. Now, these 7 tires of dolls with small furniture. At the top are always the dolls of the emperor and empress with a miniature gilded screen placed behind them. So, these are the emperor and empress in the doll set, okay? These dolls display are dedicated to peach blossoms. Momoseku is another name for the festival. Momoseku is another name for the festival, that is Hinamatsuri. Okay. Hina is an ancient word that means doll and Matsuri means festival. So you can call it a doll festival. Now let's have an interaction with the girl child from Japan. What she says, March 3 is girls festival in Japan. The day is not an official holiday, but when The girl was a child. The day was one of the most interesting days for her. Her parents gave her king and queen dolls that are called Hina dolls. These dolls were displayed for only 2 or 3 days, and she wanted for the display every year. But now she's grown. That day she could dress up and put up makeup. It was uncommon for children to use makeup, however, but she could do that on the girls' day in Japan. Okay. Her mother made special dishes. Girls' party began. Her friends, who were girls, and she would sing the song, eat delicious food. Her father would always present her a lot of flowers. In addition, she did not need to do homework on that day. Therefore, girls' festival was one of the favorite ceremonies for the girl. So that's it, students. I hope you understood the chapter. And if you liked the video, if you understood it in a better way, please press the like button. Share our video, subscribe to our channel, and press the notification bell icon. I promise you to meet in my next video. Till then, take care. Have a nice day.